Less than 1% of naturally occurring uranium consists of the isotope U-235. Only this isotope of uranium is fissile and suitable for an atomic weapon. Most uranium consists of U-238, a nearly identical but very stable isotope. The challenge was to separate the two isotopes and produce high concentrations of U-235, or enriched uranium. As Manhattan Project veteran Bill Wilcox explains, Project Director General Leslie Groves was impressed by Ernest O. Lawrence and the potential of his approach developed at the University of California.
During those first 2 months, General Groves had the job of going around talking to these university scientists about how this incredibly difficult job of separating uranium-235 from U-238 could possibly be done. Then he goes to Berkeley, California, and he talks to Professor E.O. Lawrence, who is Mr. Enthusiasm about, by gosh, I'm quite sure we can do this using a modification of a cyclotron that I developed. And he explains this to Groves, and I'm sure Groves, when he saw this huge, huge cyclotron, these big magnets and these tubes and devices, I'd love to know what he thought. But he hadn't separated anything to amount to micrograms of U-235, but was enthusiastic. And so at the end of December, Groves made that decision. We're going to go with Lawrence's process. That's probably the best bet. And that's what turned into the Y-12 plant.
Designed at the University of California, the electromagnetic separation plants were called calutrons. Cal stood for California, U for University, Tron for cyclotron, Cal-U-Tron.